What's up and welcome to the 6th placement game of my rank climb. For today, I'm going to be playing as Garen in the top lane versus Riven. Okay, so this is actually a pretty interesting matchup because, you know, Garen is not really considered that strong these days. Like, a lot of people avoid him and only really pick him, like, during specific moments. Like, let's say, what would actually be, like, a good... like really good lane for Garen? I'm not actually sure. I'm trying to think of it. Actually, what is Garen's like best matchup? I'm sure there was one, but I can't think of it right now. Well, generally speaking, he does pretty decently against melee champions, but I do know for a fact that he can struggle against Darius sometimes. Yeah, like he's a pretty interesting champion because, you know, even though he's so super simple, he's actually pretty strong as an early laner because of his, you know, base damages on his spells. It's actually really easy to just creep up on someone and then just destroy them. But I'm not gonna lie, I have heard a lot of conflicting things about Garen versus Riven. I know that when Garen was at his strongest, a lot of people couldn't stop him, and people were forced to like play Gnar against him and stuff. But I don't know what he's like against Riven. I think he is better, but I've seen a lot of Rivens outplay Garen's in the past, so I feel like it's a skill matchup, as ironic as that may sound, because, you know, Garen doesn't really require much skill. But definitely on the Riven's part, there's a skill ceiling. And what is this? Ivan is actually AFK base. Is this actually gonna be a remake? Oh no. I hope not. Anyways, let's go ahead and see if there's gonna be anything to land against here. Oh, wow, Riven is missing from top side too. Okay then. Well, I guess I'm just gonna start shoving it out and try to get a lead from like this. Go ahead and do this. Oh, come on. There we go. Here's Riven, but Ivern is still back at base. It would be pretty sad if we like had to actually play this game out. But you know, chances are Ivern's actually gonna come back by the time like the remake timer is about to set off, and then, you know, we can never make a remake because he comes back at the right time. That has happened to me so many times, it's not even funny. Holy crap, this is actually going somewhat decently. I'm not taking too much damage and I'm just dealing damage to her. Yeah, I guess this is gonna be a remake from the looks of it. Oh, clutch. This always happens without fail. Oh god, under the turret. Okay, this is not good anymore. Maybe I should have gone ignite. Oh dude, this is so cocky because I'm getting close to killing her, but yeah, like before having ultimate. Oh wow. Oh, I kind of feel like I should have turned there at the last second. Eve at my red. Uh-oh. Ivern's already getting, like, zoned out, I guess. Oh, hang on. Wait, should I have put a point into the... Wait, she's dead! Oh, no. Riven, no F. Damn it. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have gone for the grass of them dying. Maybe I should have gone for, like, what's the other one called again? Thunderlord's Decree. Yeah, maybe that could have been better. Damn it. Oh well. Let's see. I'm just gonna go for a longsword and a health pot. I wonder if Jones Ghostblade Garen is legit. Hang on, let me see her like do damage to this thing and then teleport to it. Here we go. That's gonna bother her a little bit. Oh, you gotta run. Oh, she's dead. No, this shield. Oh my god, I really dislike Riven Shield, dude. It's like the most ridiculous spell. Skills off of AD. Get such a low cooldown eventually, and it's just, oh man. Stupid champion. Oh well, at least I kind of had a little bit of a lead from that. Let's go ahead and hit these minions. Okay. I do kind of feel like I might have made a mistake by not putting a point into W early. I forgot about the whole stacking thing, where like whenever you last hit something, you get free armor and mag resistance, and that's actually pretty big. Especially when, you know, people don't have Lethality yet. Oh, really? Under the turret? She got silenced for a long time there. Oh yeah, I forgot about Garen's new E passive. You actually shred armor like it's a Black Cleaver now. Oh my god, that's too funny. That actually worked. Use the ribbon teleports and, you know, use the eye to the turret because of silence. I guess she kind of was underestimating the fact that, you know, silence would, like, have her take so much damage from the turret. Oh man, and then of course my armor reducing passive on the E. Wait, is it only to him though? Wait. Hang on, what's it? Where is it? Enemy champions. Okay, so it's not an exclusive armor penetration. It's actually, you know, from every source that gets like an armor pen. Okay, I thought maybe, you know, Garen's E only gave like Garen specifically armor pen, and like anyone else, it was just be the same, right? But no, it seems like you actually do reduce their armor, so that's kind of cool. Anyway, so what do I do here? Do I really go for like start going for like a Black Cleaver build, or do I go for the whole like Jomo's Ghostblade? I feel like Jomo's Ghostblade is really cheeky, but I really want to see what that's like, so I'm gonna start building Jomo's Ghostblade. All right, let's just go ahead and start running up towards topside again. Oh, look at this, Ivern and Evelynn fighting. I'm gonna ping because, you know, this Anivia is obviously moving over. And yeah, Fizz is not gonna be there. So I'm kinda happy I pinged there. Maybe Ivern wouldn't have paid attention fast enough. Topside is missing. How is Ivern doing? Level 3 to level 4. Oh, he's not that behind. Has Evelynn been ganking a lot? I mean, he's gonna be a little bit behind now that he's been forced to use his flash, but could definitely have been worse, right? Yeah. Okay. Pushing out the lane a little bit without wanting to, but I didn't want to miss too many minions. Let's put a ward here. Where's that Riven? I got my ultimate now, so maybe we can do some sick damage there. She jumps away. This is like one of the most boring parts about playing against Riven. When you're playing something that's actually good against her, like, she can play so defensively. It's really ridiculous how, like, Riven is so flexible when it comes to, like, play styles. Like, you can play defensively, you can play offensively. Like, she's definitely the opposite to what I said Leona was as a champion yesterday. Where, like, you know, if Riven, when you're going in, you actually have some options to, like, go out, right? Okay, it depends also as well how many things you used as you were going in. Oh, am I getting ganked? That's the only reason I can imagine this is happening. Oh, my ultimate was about to hit her, but I don't think it would have been enough to kill her. Yeah, I kind of underestimated her a little bit. This is one of those situations where you kind of wish you went tanky instead of going full damage. Oh, that is bullshit. I thought I could do more damage to her before she could do that kind of damage to me. But then again, her freaking ultimate is an execute. That kind of sucks. It's okay. Let's just go ahead and try and finish off the Jomo's Ghostblade at least before moving on to Black Cleaver. But it was kind of weird that Riven suddenly went ham on me. It kind of felt like, you know, Evelynn was coming top, so no matter what I did there, I felt like I was gonna die. And apparently, according to Ivern, Evelynn was top, so yeah. Okay, let's just keep running towards top. Come on, come on. Almost there. Here we are. Missing minions, of course. How's the farm? 46 to 42. So even though she did get a kill on me, I'm still in the farm lead, so I guess that's cool. Alright. Anyways, I'm not sure where this Riven has gone. I guess knowing that her ultimate is on cooldown now is gonna be kinda cool, because that means, you know, I'm probably gonna be able to do something against her without getting, like, too punished. Oh, that hit her. Oh, hang on. I mean, why does she deal so much? Like, auto-attack. No! I was gonna do auto-attack then ult, but the ult never went off. Riv, no flash. Oh, now I felt like I shouldn't have done the flash there. Is she? Oh, no. Now my silence on cooldown. Come on! No! Minions didn't kill her! Oh my god, dude. Oh, no. Stupid shield of Riven, man. Whatever. Let's go ahead and get the Caulfield's Warhammer. Let's look at what's happening middle. Whoa. That's a kill to Nivea, right? Oh my god, it's stun. No, she's gonna get her egg popped at least. Wow, this Fizz though. Oh nice, they just managed to avoid the ultimate from Ashe. Wow, and they actually get her killed. Oh, but here comes Evelynn. Is she gonna clean up the day? Do I bother teleporting here? Okay, I'm teleporting in. I'm coming, dude. Root her, something. Wow, under the turret, though. No, she's gonna suicide just to deny me the kill. Wow, that is such bull, man. Alright, maybe I should have done that sooner. I don't know. I feel like she would have used, like, suicide, I guess, the same. Alright, I pushed out middle at least, so there's that. Let's go on towards topside. Is Ribbon waiting for me, like, here? Probably. I'll take the safe way. Ribbon is probably a little bit stronger than me right now. Which is kind of shitty because, yeah, I definitely was playing around a little bit too much in the lane. And she doesn't seem to be a particularly bad Ribbon. Like, okay, that one moment under the turret kind of made her look bad. But other than that, like, you know, it's kind of been looking okay. Oh, I was trying to move ahead of her. Oh, no, she's going to be farming me now. Oh, well. Let's go ahead and get boots. Garen, a tip. If you go tank, you will not die against Ribbon. Wow, a tip. Don't try to flash for against the mobile champion if you're just gonna hit a skill shot. Oh wow, is Ivern actually gonna be able to do this? Oh wow, the Grump actually finished her off. Nice, that was actually pretty stylish. Although I get the feeling that that wasn't really intentional. I think he was just trying to catch the Ribbon over the wall. Still, looked cool. Oh shit, oh man, Tom Kench, the team player. Kind of. Oh, that was a little bit too late, wasn't it? Shouldn't that have come out a little bit sooner? Oh, man. Oh, well. I've died 3 times to the Ribbon now. She's caught up in farm. Things are looking pretty bad for me right now. I'm not gonna lie, though. I kind of underestimated the fact that... whoa! Okay, I'm gonna have to cure and start running away. Okay, it looks like Ivern is actually interested in helping me out. I don't think Ribbon has, like, oh! Whoa! Hang on, I'm gonna get her! Got her with the silence! No, get her! Get her! No! Are you kidding me right now? Oh! No, I wanted to ult her. What's the range of this ult? Did they reduce the ultimate range of Garen? I swear to god they did. Anyways, in the meantime, yeah, they got Dragon. That kind of sucks. Oh, she's so low health. But I know the moment she's going to come in, she's going to shield. And that's going to suck. But hey, look at my health, though. My regen is crazy. I'm almost back to full health. Holy crap. That's cool. Got that. That fishy blue. Oh, he's talking about Fizz. I kind of want to kill her under the turret. But I have to bait out the shield first somehow. That's the thing about Garen though, there's no real way to bait out except putting your Q on cooldown, which is like kind of not good. Okay, Anivia's here, so it's time to start running. See ya. Wow, what is this? This is bullying! Oh wow, Ribbon missed her ult, but I'm still dead. Oh my god, man. I saw the Anivia and I was like, okay, maybe I can get away from this. But then like the Evelyn came from behind with her ult. That is bull. Oh man, are they gonna do something bot lane at least? Maybe not. Man, look at how low Ribbon got though. This is so sad though. Oh shit. Let's go ahead and get Jones Ghost played. Wait, what? He died to her? Oh well. I don't know about that, but yeah, she's definitely a little bit fed now. She's got 4 kills. But it kind of seems strange to me that, you know, Ivern would just gladly stand in front of Ribbon like that. It did seem a little bit too much of a risk that wasn't worth taking. Okay, anyways, let's just push out the lane. And I guess we're gonna start using the teleport to actually gank some lanes now because, yeah, I feel like, trying to kill the Ribbon is going to be a little bit fruitless now that she's gotten this far ahead. I mean, as Garen, you do have that early laning phase that I said, and you know, you kind of want to stay ahead at all times. Nice. Wow, is Fizz going to literally 1v2 here? Holy. Oh, he only got the egg. That sucks. Oh, I can't even help him now. Alright, let's put a ward here. But that was pretty insane. Fizz 1v2ing. That's actually... Oh, he's got a Negatron Cloak. Okay, so he's like reducing both of their damage quite a lot. Oh man, blue buff Ribbon. How much CDR? 28%. How's my DW? Is it fully stacked? I don't think it is. Oh, no. Okay, now I'm gonna do my W. Dude, this Keystone Mastery, Grassland Undying, really is weak on Garen. It doesn't really feel that good at all. Oh, hang on. Oh, no! Are you kidding me? Oh, how slow is the ultimate of Garen, though? It was in midair. Oh, man. My team is probably gonna think I'm intentionally feeding. I'm kind of, like, just trying to see, like, what I can actually do against her, but... Holy shit, the Q is... Silence is so weak. How long is it? 1.5 seconds. Does this silence become stronger the more points I put into it? I think they changed that, so it's only like you get movement speed when you upgrade your Q. But if it's not, then maybe I guess maxing out Q first could be better against someone like Riven. Anyways, let's go ahead and start building Black Cleaver, I guess. Yep. Oh shit, what happened here though? Okay. Okay, people are getting a little bit pessimistic here. They haven't even dealt with the Riven yet, so yeah, it's gonna be kind of interesting when Riven gets part of the mix. I've definitely let this lane go a little bit too far. I don't really think there's anything I can do right now to actually win in a 1v1, other than wishing that I probably didn't go for like Grassland Undying, because right now that's not really helping me since I'm not even building health. Yeah, going Thunderlords I think would have been better. Oh, hang on. We're actually gonna do this? Oh, hang on. Wait. Oh, wait. Fizz didn't have anything to throw at her. No way, dude. She left me low enough health so that freaking Nivea could just auto-attack me. Oh my god, that's so lame. Anyways, yeah. That is pretty much... This pretty much comes down to the fact that I opted for, like, the Jomo's Ghostly build. I don't know, man. I thought maybe I could get away with the Jomo's Ghostly, but it seems like I could not. I probably should have gone for something like Sunfire Cape or even the Black Cleaver first. I thought maybe it could work, but apparently it does not, so that kind of sucks. Oh well, I'll know now for my future games that on Garen, you definitely don't want to rush Jomo's Ghostly. Oh shit, he just walked. Like, past the Evelyn. Okay, she flashes. But I'm a little bit surprised, though, by how fast the Riven gets to, like, regain control of her character. Uh-oh. Yeah. But it doesn't seem to be like Riven is the only problem in this game, though. It seems like both AD Carry and Jungle got fed this game. Garen learned one lesson? But I got the first kill, though. I was not behind this game. Didn't I get the first kill in lane? I think I did. So yeah. I don't know. Like, I guess afterwards I could be building armor. But I seriously felt like even if I built a little bit of armor, it wouldn't really do too much against her lethality. So I don't really feel like I did too much wrong. Yeah. Anyways, shitty games happen. I mean, I'm not taking this game too seriously. I've already won, like, quite a few games in my placements. Oh well, they got the Riven at least. But that doesn't mean I'm not gonna try. Like, I'm just gonna finish off my build as I intended it to, which is like the Black Cleaver after the Yuma's Ghostblade. Afterwards, I guess I'll have to think about getting like a Deadman's Blade maybe. Yeah, Deadman's Blade probably makes the most sense, although they do have a lot of mag resistance. Maybe Hexdrinker at some point too. Just get that AD built up. So wait, is the Q? No, the Q doesn't go up. In silence whenever you leveled up, so it is a 1.1 there. But you do get more movement speed, and I think movement speed duration when you level up the Q. Oh wow, okay, there's the Avalon. Is she gonna start running? Yes, she is. Right into me! Yes! Get executed. Alright, let's just go back to base and... wait. Oh shit, I accidentally took the blue buff! Okay, I'm serious. I did not mean to do that. I just wanted to recall in a safe spot. No, dude. Oh god, I'm actually looking like a troll now to my team, which is kind of sad. That was seriously not my intention. Yeah, that was a mistake for sure. Anyways, I guess it's also worth mentioning, like, I know you guys know me for like making up excuses and stuff, but I pretty much woke up like half an hour ago, so please, I usually don't want to make excuses as much as I used to in the past, but I am actually feeling a little bit groggy, so please bear with me. What's with the pings? Pinging me off bot side? Dude, I'm like already here. You gotta stay middle because there's a fight about to start off. I have teleport, so it makes the most sense that I split push, right? Okay, nice. They got the ribbon. That's cool. Let's go ahead and get these. Is my W fully stacked? I can't tell. No, it's not. It's like 30, right? That's maximum stacks. Nice. I'm actually getting some pretty decent losses here. Gonna get to 30 pretty soon. Can I get the tower? Oh man, it's full health. I'm never gonna get the tower. Wait, what's going on? Did they just not fight with everybody ready? I'm just gonna keep working until I can get like the tower low. Okay, time to go. Whoa! I was gonna say time to go back, and then that shit happens. This is scary. Wait, did Morgana just miss me on the way out? Yeah, she did. I thought maybe there were more than just Morgana there. Okay, I was safe. Anyways, I did get some pretty decent gold from that, but I still don't have enough for Black Cleaver. I kind of want to get the Black Cleaver first. It looks like the team is having some infighting right now that's not about me, so I guess I kind of feel a little bit better about that. They are also having issues with each other. Oh, dude, that Ashe has like my passive mark on her. Maybe I can get her? Come on, let's go. No way, dude. Alright, wait, no! Wait. No, you gotta be kidding me, really? Okay, they get her at least. Hey, I got an assist. Oh, this is so sick. Look at this. Clutch. The last second going in. My sacrifice was worth it. Look at that. Nice. Okay. How much do I need for this? 250. Nice. Oh, okay. He doesn't die to the Anivia stun. Cool. It was all worth it. Look at that. What's he doing, though? He's chasing the Morgana. He's going to end up getting rooted and then like he's wasting his time. Alright, anyways, that Baron and assist gold were like really nice. Can finally get my Black Cleaver. Let's go ahead and get the, what's it called? A control ward. And do I just go for topside? Yes, I guess. Yeah, that kind of sucked though that I just randomly got killed. I didn't even realize that Riven had like that low health. I only saw like Ashe and her little like passive thing, and I remember, you know, Ashe is pretty strong, but she's an AD carry, so like if I can get on top of her, she's 100% dead. And then like my flash came up out of nowhere, and I was like, god damn it, you know, I should have waited till my flash was up so I could use flash Q her, and then she would be pretty screwed. But at least I did make her use her ultimate against me, which is, you know, it enabled the rest of my team to do as they liked. So yeah, I'm not too upset at that low effort that I did there. I think it was alright. Got him low, you know, I distracted him, I made Riven turn around and take some more damage. Yeah, that's pretty good. Let's put a ward in this brush here. And let's move back. Oh, my team is like winning fights on their own too. That's cool. That means I can just stay topside and catch up a little bit through farm. Yeah, it seems like the enemy team is being caught out like completely out of place. And that's making them get like some advantageous fight. Guerrilla warfare. Okay, let's go ahead and start working on the top side because yeah, Riven is still dead, so that's gonna allow me to do a lot. Nice, look at that, my team is just killing people. How is that happening? Oh, they got split up by the Anivia Welder. All right in the meantime, he's gonna work on the turret, doing work, of course using Q on every cooldown that I can. There we go. Nice. Look at that. So, you know, going AD wasn't so bad in the end because that's allowing me to kill the turrets quicker. Okay, here comes Morgana and the Riven. Riven has triggered her Edge of Night, so I guess she wanted to fight. Oh man, Edge of Night. Being able to block Garen's silence is actually pretty devastating. Okay, anyways. Is this gonna be a Ninja Tabby game? I don't think so, even though Ninja Tabby is a strong item. I think it's a Merc Treads game, just because all their stuff. Okay, let's just go for armor now. There we go. Now my team's got to be happy a little bit. Do we teleport for this? It's a little bit too late to teleport, I feel. Holy shit, they're dealing a lot of damage to the Riven, though. She's dead. Okay, then. Nice. So they still managed to get through it. There's the Ash. Can I catch her? Oh, I'm coming. Let's go, go, go. Oh, she doesn't see me because of the brushes. Oh, no, my justice. Come on, Tom Kench. That wasn't necessary. Come on, man. Oh, that was so my kill, dude. Oh, well. Whoa. I'm guessing she's going to try and... Wait. No, she's so fast. I wanted to ult her, but then she got out of range. I wanted to see if she was actually low enough by the time I ulted. Damn it. Oh, man, that's so shitty. Stupid fed Evelynn. Well, she's not even that fed. She's only got 5 kills. At least I made Evelynn sweat a little bit. Let's go to top, I guess. And just take care of that farm. Oh, look, it's Varus here. Alright, I'll jump over. See if I can catch someone. Nope, nobody's here. Riven is still bot side. Maybe we can catch someone in the jungle? Oh, there's Evelynn. She's full health already. How did that happen? Okay, hang on. No, wait. I'm not going to be able to catch him. Even with Tom Kench, it doesn't make much sense. Oh, cool. Fizz is actually strong enough to one-shot most people. That's good. That's probably what's been keeping us in the game so far. Let's go ahead and do this. Q. And let's catch him from behind. Oh, no. Where's my team, though? Oh, no. Wait, they weren't following up? Oh, my God. I really thought they were going to go in with me there. I was like, I'm flanking them, right? Oh, my God. I'm not tanky enough to pull that shit off. Especially when dealing with someone like Anivia and all their crowd control altogether. Stun, stun, stun. That's a lot of stuns. The main reason why I'm not talking back to them in chat is because if I do talk back, I give reason for them to type back to me, right? Like, the last thing I actually want to happen in this game is to have an actual conversation with my team about why I'm doing badly, right? Like, I don't have to explain why I'm doing badly. I use them, right? Like, there's no reason to tell them. Like, even if I tell them, oh, it's because I'm feeling very tired, like, that's just gonna trigger them to like, talk more. So, in this case, it is actually better to just let them talk on and just, you know, try to do your best and, you know, eventually do some good things here and there. But right now, I'm 2-8-2. Holy shit, I think this is my worst score so far. Yeah, by far, this is my worst score so far. Even in the first game that I lost, I think I still had like a positive KDA. This is far from a positive KDA. And if I want to somehow come back from this, like, to get a good KDA again, like, I'd require a miracle. Wow, I'm actually dealing decent damage. Alright, let's get this thing pushed out. I would love to get level 16 so I can get my level 2 ult. Is my team? Nope. I'm kind of getting trust issues with my team now. I seriously did think they were going to like chase into them and like go into them there, but they did not. Can I just catch this? Oh, hang on. Oh, and ulted. There we go. I'm going to try and block, yes, all the W shots from Ash onto the Fizz. Wait, I'm waiting for this shield to run off. There we go. Auto attacker. No! You gotta be kidding me, though. Okay, flash out of the Morgana ult. Hey, come on. Catch her. I kept them busy long enough. There we go, team. Nice, nice. All right, look at that. Get in me. Get me in there. Not get in me. I'm not the Tom Kench. All right, Jumbo's Ghost Blade. Chase, here we go. Oh, I'm too fast for you. I gotta dodge the... Oh, okay. Never mind. Wow. Sidestep? 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 Okay. Nice. That's a stun. No! Tom! Not again, dude! Oh my god. This guy keeps taking the kills. Why? He's just a support. I need the gold. Come on, man. Alright, whatever. Let's just go back to base. And, buy Demon's Plate, right? I really should have looked up what people have been building recently on this guy. Oh, no catch. Okay, we're never gonna reach her in time then. Or? Holy, okay, never mind. Maybe I should use my ultimate on her? Was it really on off cooldown though? Oh, nice. I actually got out of that even though, like, she made up a wall. Oh, wait, aren't you supposed to, like, go, like, boost the swiftness on Garen? I think so. No, don't pink freaking Baron though. Let's go to the bot side. That's a huge wave that really needs to be taken care of. Why is Garrus pinging that? I mean, why is Varus pinging that he's on the way? I'm already there, dude. Like, there's no reason. I'm the one with teleport. I'm the one that should be taking care of this wave anyway. So I don't know why he's doing this. Oh shit. Yeah, why did he go back? Look, there's a big fight going on now. Anything in TP2? Nope. They got Baron buff off of that, but can we win the fight? Wow, what's with this pathing? Okay, well, I missed that. Oh shit. Nice, they managed to get the ribbon killed anyway. Oh wow, that sucks. Let's go ahead and auto attack the turret. Q. Whoa, careful. Okay, she didn't have ultimate ready. I guess it's on cooldown. Okay, time to run out. Wow, look at that. This sidestep of justice. Alright. Oh, blue trinket. Get rid of this thing. Start going back now. Okay, so I can finally buy this thing. Kind of been wanting it forever now. Additional movement speed is going to be nice. So now the question is, do I go for armor or do I go for MR? I think armor is the right choice because right now the enemy team doesn't seem to be doing that much magic damage. I guess a little bit, but I guess I can start off by just building a ruby crystal. You know, getting some health. Okay. Go ahead and put a control ward here. I still haven't placed my control ward. That was kind of shitty though that he got the Baron for free there. Don't feel like it was necessary to let them get that. I mean, I was showing myself topside, but like Varus did not need to do that as well. I felt like that was a little bit too much of a waste of time. Of course, by seeing two people topside, they're gonna feel super safe doing Baron. I mean, they did kind of pay for it, but they still have a bit of the Baron buff left on them. I was with the pinks to be careful. Like, I can handle this. Can't I? Oh my god, wait. Oh god. Okay, he gets eaten up at least. Oh no, hang on. He doesn't have enough to do with Sony's Hourglass. Okay, time to go back. Like, that Tom Kenji is super dead. There's way too many people down bot lane. Sonya's 1 second. Yeah, if he had Sonya's, maybe he could have done something sick there. Alright, here comes the Baron buff. Whoa! Can you pop like this shield somehow with auto-attacks? I'm gonna keep auto-attacking her till it pops. Whoa, what's going on here though? He just gets... Oh my god, we got shrekt! No! No! Oh, I was trying to ult there at the last second! Oh my god. Okay. Anyways, I think the enemy team ends up winning this anyway. Let them have the turret. What the fuck are you doing? Yeah, that wasn't even me that was like trying to defend the turret. I was actually like trying to push away the ribbon, and then when I saw the fight, I was like, okay, I guess I need to fight this. But in retrospective, maybe I shouldn't have fought at all. I should just let them have the turret and the kills. Maybe we can still defend this though? The 80 Shammies aren't focusing the Nexus. Oh, they are now. Oh, it's over. Whoa! Oh no, it's not gonna be enough. Oh well, that was my Garen gameplay. Unfortunately, I learned the hard way that you probably should always go tank on Garen, even if you're dealing with a melee champion, or at least if you're dealing with someone like Revan. Oh man, I feel like I did really let my team down here by building Jomo's Ghostly first. Yeah. Anyways, yeah, I guess this could be as a lesson for everybody who's watching. You know, if you're playing Garen, don't try to go AD first. Like, it just doesn't work that well because you're a melee champion and you don't exactly have a gap closer that allows you to like guarantee damage. You're most definitely gonna take damage as you're going in on a person. So yeah, I guess it was quite a while ago that I played Garen that I felt like maybe this can still work even though the champion is simple. But yeah, some things you just can't get away with, and I think that was one of them. So anyways, yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next game. I'm of course gonna be playing my next placement today as well. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. Hopefully I won't be doing as badly as this time. I always take a little bit of a break between my placement games that I record, you know, twice a day, so that I feel a little bit more fresh for my next game. If I just play every game like right after each other, I'm gonna feel like really crappy. So Yeah, especially after a loss like this where I actually feel bad about my performance. A break is going to be needed a little bit. So anyways, thank you guys for watching still though, and hopefully I'll see you guys for next time. This has been Misty Rocksters.